Hi guys, it's me again. It's episode number 5 of my clearly besotted month, and here's the card that I made. I've used Anteater Antics for my card, but first I'm going to do some ink blending. And here's the stamp set. Anteater, I looked it up, it linked it down below, the one from yesterday, I couldn't find it on the website. So I'm sorry about that, I might be retired. I'm choosing my beasties. I kind of like the one with the bubble, but also the one with the net is catching butterflies. And this is the one that I'm using in the end, of course. This was bubble and ants, but I didn't color in the butterflies because I wanted them more in the background, and it would be getting too colorful and too busy on my card. And of course, my anteaters are the stars of the show, so they need to be the focus. I'm basking off the top, I'm checking if it's straight, and that will be my horizon. Now, I did look up where anteaters live, usually in South America, but their numbers have declined drastically over there, and they also live in Africa, so savannah. And I have this creative expression stamp, but I thought it's too big, so I went for the little tree from Marianne Design in the big cat set. And there's also a tuft of grass that I thought I could disperse between the anteaters, but I didn't because I changed my mind and I thought it was again too busy. And I'm making kind of a hill, grassy, knobbly terrain. This is cool to call it that. There is also this sensor from Clearly Besotted. But I thought again that would be too busy, and the grass is usually really short over there, isn't it? So I'm using Distress Inks for my background, and I'm starting with Fossilized Amber, and then Wild Honey and Rusty Hinge on the bottom, so that gives you a variegated terrain that is kind of like dried out grass, muddy maybe, I don't know. You do it, and I just rip off a little bit more and use the same post-it. And then I was like, oh, which one did I use? Yep, that was the right order. Wild Honey, and I sped this up 300 times, and then I switch hands. Yeah, and I pull up my sleeves because, you know, just in case I get inky, I don't want that to happen to me. I got paint on my nice t-shirt and a long sleeve. I have always a long sleeve in the winter and short sleeve funny t-shirt on top. And they're painting at work, and I didn't see. When I went home, there was white. So I'm trying to be more careful. Of course, these are water based, so that wouldn't be too much of a problem. But I'm talking a lot while I ink blend. Of course, I'm trying to work towards the white bit, but I don't want any white because that would be very stark and not very nice, I don't think. So a little bit, but I went over the first one with the middle one. You can see there's like a bump in the middle, but I think that's where I end up with my butterflies. But by that time it had kind of seeped in the paper, so I can't see it anymore. And the tuft of grass, I just mounted it on a block so I can move it quickly. And I'm just testing it with the same distress inks, but these are silicone or acrylic stamps, and it's just not very nice. So I pulled out VersaFine Vintage Sepia, which you can see the different bubbly, not bubbly, but smooth. So really good. And I'm using only the, I don't know, acacia tree, and African tree, because I don't know. The sentiments in the anteater sets are, I think, more for spring and stuff. And so I pulled out the Laugh Out Loud set as well, also Clearly Besotted. And I'm using the one, when I reach your age, I'll still be younger than you. It makes me giggle because it's funny. Yes. Well, I, yeah. This, yeah. I'm going to give this to my friend that is 10 years older than me. And, and I don't know if he will appreciate it, but I think he will. So, I'm stamping the sentiment and I'm cleaning it. Is it new stamp? Of course, I need to wipe it properly and then check it again. And I want stamp it once. These are very fine font. And I don't want to do some repeat stamping in case it gets too juicy, you know. And then I'm using VersaFine black ink here, just because it's a sentiment. Yeah, I like my sentiments black. I know I'm weird, but I do. It's that comic book feeling, graphic design stuff. But yeah, but the trees, they're fine if they're brown. I mean, they would be a little bit stark if they were black, I think. So then I'm using that vintage sepia. And I'm just doing two because I think it's full. I'm one little bit off. Yeah, makes it more playful. I think, anyway. Yeah, and I'm leaving my grass to the end until I know where my anteaters will go. I think something like this would be a great arrangement. And then I can stamp the butterflies. Like he's catching them. And then I moved it. I don't know why. But yeah. Actually, I know why. Because the one on the bottom is looking at them. And if they were more to the left, he wasn't looking at them. So for the coloring, I will turn on the music and say goodbye, because I'll see you tomorrow. I just mounted the beasts with foam tape and adhered to the card base, and that's pretty much it. So thank you for watching. I'll see you again. Oh, before I go, the sets that I could find are linked down below. And for the disclaimer, I want to say I bought all these myself. I'm not sponsored, but I have so many, I needed to put them to good use. So you get me every day during the week. So thank you for watching. I'll see you again soon. Until then, bye.